I'm a confused economist on purpose. I believe that if you're not confused, you're not thinking. And I'm an eclectic economist. People concentrate on my Marxism, but I keep saying, and they don't take the first adjective seriously, that I'm a libertarian Marxist. So my influences are just as much Hayek and von Mises as it is Marx and Keynes. Now, that sounds strange. How can you have influence from Hayek, Mises, Marx, and Keynes?
Yeah.
I think that it's the only way of understanding capitalism and being sensible about it. Each one of us, of those thinkers, has given us very important tools and concepts. So Marx was the first economist to come up with the theory of the business cycle, of the boom and bust. Mm-hmm. There was no theory of boom and bust before that. Adam Smith didn't have it. David Ricardo had the theory of stagnation, but no theory of cycles. The idea, when we talk about disruptive technologies, that's Marx. If you read even the Communist Manifesto, it's the way that technology disrupts the social relations of production and creates a new mode of production. It went mm-hmm. from feudalism through the steam engine destroyed feudalism and brought in capitalism. In my estimation, robotics, 3D printers, and so on will bring the end of what we know as capitalism, bringing in some other mode of production. I don't know what we're going to call it. Hopefully, it will be a good world to live in, but it will be something very different.
Right.
There will be no purpose for corporations anymore because the economies of scale will have been devastated by technology. So that's what I learned from Marx. This is crucial for me from Marx. Also, the idea there is no such thing as a natural economic system. It's an evolving thing. That's from Marx. Schumpeter got it all from Marx anyway. If you read Schumpeter, who is a doyen of the right, he himself admits that even though his politics were right-wing, his economic theory would not have existed without Karl Marx. Hmm. When it comes to Keynes, the idea of a coordination failure, where you have a pile of savings, pile of savings and a pile of debts, and the savings are not invested into productive activities that will generate the incomes that will extinguish the debts. This coordination failure is Keynes, and nobody else has explained it as well as Keynes. Hayek was fantastic, and von Mises, doing two things. Firstly, explaining to us the true nature of the market and the true utility of the market. The market is not just a little mechanism for pushing prices to the level of costs. It's a way of disseminating information when information is very, very complicated to disseminate through some central process. The Austrian idea, the von Mises idea, that when you have a bankruptcy, you do not overcome the bankruptcy loans and through taxpayer-funded bailouts. This is one that I think is essential for all of us to understand. So these are my influences. One of the great tragedies of the 20th century is that the libertarians and the Marxists ended up with followers that they did not deserve. So, for instance, you know the story about Marx. When he was old, and just before he died, there were these young left-wing people, economists, who came to see him with, to pay their respect to the great man, and they were telling him that, we are Marxists and that we believe X, Y, Z. And he was listening to them. He said, the only thing he said to them was, "Well, if you're a Marxist, I'm not." So poor Marx did not deserve.
Those are great dying words.
Yeah. He didn't deserve Stalin. He didn't deserve, in the same way Christ did not deserve the Spanish Inquisition, right? Marx did not deserve the Soviets. Similarly, the liberals and the libertarians do not deserve all those people who speak on their name. Margaret Thatcher, who usurped the notion of free markets and shrinking the state in order to build up the state and make it more centralized and more authoritarian than ever.
Mm-hmm. So basically these labels that we use, we need them in a certain way, right? Like you've mentioned a lot of labels here. It gives us a sort of framing of all this.
Yeah.
But we're entering a time where none of it makes sense in a traditional way anymore. Is that fair to say?
Look, the world is a very complicated place. So we need different, smart, sophisticated concepts in order to make sense of it. That was never easy. If you and I were sitting here, well, not through Skype, but face-to-face in the 1920s, late 1920s, or after 1929, we would be having exactly the same amount of trouble understanding what was going on then than we do now.